at one point used to be a street boy. He was rejected by his own parents. And I took him and started taking care of him. I took him to school. And then after some time, when I came back to Nairobi, the boy was no longer in school. Then I met the professor. And when I greeted the professor, he accepted to take him. Right now, I feel so happy because my son Stephen is going to become a man.
I have passed a lot of things in my life. I have been mistreated by my mom and been told that I'm not supposed to be ready. I'm supposed to be working in the garden. Right now, I'm learning and I thank God for that.
I've been having a boy here with me, my lovely young boy. Sammy has been with me. He was born 1990. We tried very much. We took him to the best schools we could. And he did well. In the class, he's doing very well. But during the examination, he fails. He doesn't do anything. He forgets. So we really had to employ people to help the house, the schools, qualified teachers as well. But nothing. He did not do very well in 8 and 4. Eventually, we took him to Eureletico College. Very bright young man and bright. But when he sits for the examinations, he forgets everything. My friend, when I went to visit the professor, he interviewed my boy for 5 minutes. After that, he told the boy to go out and he wanted to talk with me. And he told me your boy had a problem during the bath. I looked at him. I thought first that perhaps this man, knowing education, I thought this man is a professor, but he sounded like a prophet. Because he told me exactly what happened. He said he had a problem during the bath. I said, yes. The mother had a very bad high blood pressure during the bath. And the boy was incubated for 1 month. And he said, this can be reversed, my friend. I looked at him and we finished the talk. So I just been thinking, the most serious thing which really came in my mind, why is the system in the world, particularly Kenya, Africa, we are only going for the cream, the top cream. You know milk? We only go for the cream, the old milk, I don't know whether we just throw them or we do. There are so many talented kids, but we don't have anywhere to take them. So I would like to encourage, I know that there are many parents who are suffering like we did. I thank God that I hear the president is here, both president of the world and African president. You are lucky you are here, parents. So we should encourage. We don't need to pour the old milk and only save the stream.
When I visited this place, I was actually taking my daughter here. My daughter here happened to be the other side, you understand, parents. So when you compare the two children, you can actually burden one, because this guy is sharp. I kept wondering why she cannot grasp. She has a lot of content in the mind, but when it goes to writing it down, it doesn't come. So when I was going to see the professor, I was actually taking her to find out what the problem was, and she went through the machine, and I was able to actually, as her parent now, to understand her even more.
Riziki is a student of Daystar, but we didn't really feel that we got to know exactly what she is talented in or gifted. And so we decided to take her step. And a few minutes of my daughter and I interacting with the Professor Ogura, we understood so much. I realized as a family we've struggled with things. We have been either pushing her to do things she cannot handle, or she is continuing in a course which she hadn't quite conceptualized what that may lead her into. And so a short test revealed things that we did not know. Now Riziki, for us, she is an adopted daughter. And so when the professor asked for bio data, we don't have. But he was able to help us to understand where she's coming from.
It has made me understand what my capabilities are and not to struggle too much, just to understand things and go with my giftings and talents.